Hi! If you watched the movie Predator, today's tutorial will be especially fun to follow. We are going to replicate the Predator invisibility cloak effect. Wow, that's exciting! Let's get started! First things first, let's switch to the Prime workspace. Add all your work files to the resource window. You're gonna have a Predator footage with a green background and a new backdrop with jungle or any other background. Drag the new backdrop to the scene. We'll name it Back for convenience. Duplicate the file and name the copy P+Mask. Open the copy with a double click and insert the Predator footage. Now, in the template window, start typing background. Find the background remover effect and add it to the scene. Use the eyedropper tool next to chroma key color and adjust the settings. Alright, now the Predator is in its native habitat. Go back to the template window and type HSL. Then drag the Hue Saturation Lightness effect to the scene. Double-click on the spectrum to create a control point and move it to the center. We've just removed all the colors from that layer. Back to the template window, find the Emboss effect and drag it to the scene. Then find the Brightness Contrast Gamma effect and also add it to the scene. Set the gamma level at 9. Go back to the layer above and duplicate the layer with the Predator. Let's name the original layer Relief and the copy Mask. In the copy, remove all effects except for the background remover. Meanwhile, in the background remover settings, find Output and select Alpha Channel. Next, add the negative effect to the scene and place it above the background remover. Go back to the layer placed above and duplicate the layer with the Predator. Open the Blending Mode menu and select the following. For the Mask layer, select Inverted Mask. For the Relief layer, select Overlay. The camouflage is ready. In case it came out way too invisible, change the gamma levels in the Brightness Contrast Gamma parameter for the Relief layer. The next step is to create a transition that will make the camouflage go from being visible to being invisible and backwards. To get started, go back to the main timeline tab and decide where the transition should start. Then add a marker right there. Make sure that the marker has the parameter visible in all scopes activated. Open it with a double click. In the template window, type burn and add the paper burn effect to the scene. Also notice it should be placed under the mask layer, but above the relief layer. Okay, great. Now in the properties window, find presets and select fade out, frozen from left. Place the effect so that its ending is aligned with the marker. Go back to the main timeline tab and duplicate the P+Mask layer. Place the copy under the original layer and name it Back+P for convenience. Then turn the visibility off. For the P+Mask layer, open the Back+P layer and apply Blend to the Relief layer. Open the Relief layer and remove all effects. Go back to the main timeline tab and shorten the P+Mask layer until you reach the marker. And make the P+Mask layer visible again. Oh, by the way, if your background is dynamic, we can make it so that the Predator will be moving alone. Here's how to do it. right mouse click on the original backdrop, and select Create Movement Map. Find a spot where you'd like to place the predator, select this area, and hit Start Analysis. Once the movement map is ready, remove the back plus peep layer, open the peep plus mask layer, then select all layers and convert them into a sprite. Open the sprite, hit Add Object, proceed to Movement and select Movement Map. Select all the layers and place the predator where it should be. Go back to the main timeline tab and duplicate the P plus mask layer. Rename it into back plus P and increase the duration. Open the layer, open the sprite, finally apply blend from the blending mode menu to the relief layer and remove the transition layer. And remove everything. I know it wasn't easy or fast, but it looks quite impressive. We hope you enjoyed this tutorial. Let us know what you think in the comments below. Until next time.